Howdy y'all, it's Russell back, and on today's video, we're going to be changing the Dorale spin-on transmission fluid filter that's right here. I use the Wix XP51085, and I do this annually, so let me get everything set up, and we're going to change this filter, and then we're going to go and cut the filter open and see if there are any metallic particles inside of here. And we'll see what kind of condition it is after 1 year. All right, so I'm gonna take the magnet off first. I keep a, this just is a magnet that came out of a computer hard drive. Put that aside. I've got these pig pads that absorb oil. There will be a little bit of spillage. Shouldn't be too much. Alright, so see, well, probably gonna need to get me a filter wrench because I can't get my hand, get a good grip on it down here. Alright, so I've got my regular filter wrench here. We're gonna see if I can get this in here. Oops, gotta go the other way. It's really tight with room in here because of the hoses. Okay, so I can probably do the rest by hand. Okay. Alright, there we go. Now that fluid is over a year old and it looks like it's still brand new. All right, so I've got my brand new filter. I'm gonna put just a little bit of fluid right there. I'm gonna wipe this off, make sure there's no debris. So I'm gonna go ahead and pre-fill the actual filter. Your eye thinks it's not in there, but it is obviously. All right, so I'm going to show you guys on the dipstick how clean the fluid is. This fluid is the same color as it comes out of the bottle. And it's several years old. I don't know why more people don't use these spin-on filters. If you're wondering, this has a rebuilt 700R transmission in it. All right, let's go cut the old filter open. All right, so this is the Long Acre oil filter cutter that I use. And it's very easy. We'll just open the jaws up all the way. All right, now we'll just tighten them, just snug them down. Grip it like that. And then I'll spin this around. And as I go, I'm tightening the handle. It's like a quarter of a turn. Now Wix are very heavy duty filters, so they're not as easy to cut open as other brands. Okay, it's just that easy. So Alright, so I want you guys to see in the bottom. See, that's where the magnet was. So that is just some iron filings. Could be from the torque converter. It could be most of what's in a transmission that is magnetic is from the torque converter. So it's not a lot in there at all. But that's all stuff that would not be caught by your normal transmission filter, which filters, I think it's like 200 microns. It's huge. All it is a screen to keep big chunks from circulating. Of course, that's still in the transmission, but this filters, I think this is like maybe 10 microns or maybe 15. So it filters out a lot of stuff that that screen would never get. So here's the actual filter itself, and the pleating is extremely heavy duty. It's capped by these, I guess this is epoxied in here. And I'm just looking down in between the pleats for any shininess, which I don't see any at all. So this filter could have kept going for sure. But I like to do this annually to check the condition of, and you can see it's the fluid is still cherry red. It's as red as it comes out of the bottle. And now you do have a magnet on the inside of your oil transmission pan that would have caught this, or at least most of it, but I like the added benefit of having it in the filter because I just want to see the volume of it. So very pleased with what I see in this filter, or actually what I don't see, but everything looks good. It's a very healthy transmission. All right, well, I'll have a description if you ever want to cut open your oil filters, transmission filters, any metallic canister filter, you can cut it open with these. These two studs right here have bearings on them, and you can move them up if you have a really big, like a big old diesel oil filter, which are a lot wider, so it is adjustable. So you got a pretty good wide range. This is a pretty fat filter, but I'm at the end of its, pretty much at the end of its travel here. So this cutting wheel is replaceable, but it's a really high quality unit, and there's nothing like being able to see what's going on inside the filter, because that gives you a good snapshot of what's going on inside the component. All right, well guys, I hope this was helpful and entertaining, and if you are interested in the longevity of your transmission, I would definitely look into, in fact, if Amazon has a link, I'll put it, the link into these. You can use these on pretty much any transmission, any automatic, and I think it's well worth it to be able to filter down as low as this does and still maintain your regular filter that's in there. So anyway, guys, thank you very much, and I will see you on the next video.